They're like smooth pets.
If you squeeze it, you'll piss on your hand.
So, like it or not, anyone in Singapore can now eat these 16 insect species if you want to. These bugs have been approved either for us to eat or for animal feed. But the thing is, you can't just eat any bug that happens to fly into your home, right? So today, I'm going to Pasir Panjang to a farm to see how insects are grown. Along for the ride are Marcus and Reza. They are the guys behind the camera today. Okay, so we are finally here at Werms Inc. and this is Aaron. Aaron, say hi to everyone.
Hi everyone, my name is Aaron. So this is my insect farm. So this is where we breed all our insects, and let me show you around.
All right, let's go.
So over here at Werms Inc. is probably the only insect farm that has 9 different kinds of invertebrates. Yeah, so the very first insect that we started with is mealworm. So these are probably about 3 months old already. So these are the stage where they are almost going to pupate.
So if you're wondering, they're not wet or squishy, they're very dry. And the exoskeleton?
Yeah, smooth to touch.
Very smooth to touch. And they like weigh nothing at all.
If let's say there are bigger pets than ones that eats like bigger, have bigger appetites, we cannot be feeding them mealworms all the time. Right. So over here we have like superworms. So superworms are basically much larger. They are like the mealworm's older cousin. Yeah, they're also very like smooth, shiny. Superworms take a bit longer to grow. Yeah. Oh, you're very brave. So these are baby crickets. So you can see, right, they are very, very small crickets. That, wow. They look almost like...
They look like ants?
Yeah, almost like ants.
Aren't you worried they'll jump out? Because they're not covered, right?
Oh, no. So they have a height limit where they can jump to.
Oh.
Yeah, so they can't escape.
So that's it?
Yeah, that's it.
Oh, okay. And they don't grow any bigger than this?
Oh, they do. The adults are over there.
Okay, let's go see the adults. Yeah, I want to have a look at the adult crickets, and you can hear them before you actually see them. See how big they are. Whoa!
So adult crickets grow up to like about 2 cm.
And likewise, these are not covered, so they won't jump out.
Correct. So ventilation is very important for any form of insects. We have 8 crates to create more space for them, living space, so that they don't fight, because crickets are territorial. The 8 crates also provide like some sort of warmth, traps the heat inside, and also keep it very dry, yeah, and dark. Towards the rear end, right, you can see some of them have this stick coming up. So those are the ovipositors of the female cricket. They use it to lay eggs, stick it into the soil and lay eggs.
I see, okay. In one box, how many crickets would you have?
We can keep up to 3,000.
3,000 in one box? And how quickly do they grow from that small pinhead size to like this size?
They take about a month.
A month?
A month, just a month.
And these egg crates, right?
Yep.
You would get them from the market, it's all recycled stuff?
Correct, it's all recycled stuff.
And these veggies, see what they're eating? They're eating like discarded lettuce?
Yeah. So these are from the wholesale centre, where once it comes into Singapore, they deem it as not for sale, not available for sale.
Like cosmetically ugly.
Cosmetically filtered food.
So apart from the insects, the crickets and the mealworms, you also breed earthworms.
Yeah, earthworms. So
which ones are these ones?
These are Malaysian blueworms. These are mushroom spore bags. So basically, mushroom farms that finish growing the mushroom already, right? The spore bags will be thrown away. It's discarded because it's useless already.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. So most of our customers buy earthworms for vermicomposting purpose.
Ah, so for gardening and stuff.
Gardening.
Okay, so this wouldn't be fed to fish or anything?
It can be.
Alright, so we are here on a Tuesday morning and these bags have been packed for customers. This one has crickets, mealworms, superworms, and these ones are quite special. You can come have a look at this. What are these ones?
Yeah, so these are gut-loaded superworms. So we gut-load some of our insects based on requirements. So there's a nutritional transfer.
Okay, so this one is is beta carotene. That's why these superworms are a bit pink. And this is fish feet?
Fish feet. So these are a bit high beta carotene fish feet. So it's for the color enhancement of the ornamental fish. So for this one, it's like calcium. For pet owners like with chickens, they want their chickens to have healthier eggs. Okay. So it's higher calcium feed.
So what they're eating chicken feed?
Yeah, with high calcium.
Okay. High calcium chicken feed. So they're a bit more nutritious for the chooks.
Yes.
Yay. This is wheat bran that the mealworms eat, is it?
Yeah, wheat bran. So basically the outer layer of the wheat grain.
So the husk. That,
yes, something like rice husks, but if it's from wheat grain. Yeah.
But this is stuff that we don't eat, right? Okay, so nobody wants it, but the insects will eat it.
Okay.
Ah, very cool.
We are very demand driven. So only when we see the demand, then we will start breeding more. Because these are all very short shelf life products.
Down the road, are you going to start growing insects for humans?
Yes, we are looking to create a brand that is a go-to brand for people who want to first try out insect diets. Yeah, so like a snack brand maybe. So the most commonly farmed one will be crickets for human consumption, so we'll start there. The flavor profile is the most acceptable for first-timers. What we'll be doing is using the flour and turn them into like chips. Or protein bar.
Protein powder. So what are the hurdles that you have to overcome in order to set up a facility to grow insects for us to eat?
So for insect farming for human consumption, it's a very different ballgame because the whole facility will be different. The PPE requirements as well. So we need to be clean, like, you know, have very sterile, like masks, hair nets, gloves to keep it really, really clean, like in a food factory would.
So we're done with the farm tour, and I have to say I'm really impressed that almost nothing here goes to waste. And these little guys, look at him, he's so cute and he's really grown on me. So I've given him a name, he's called Bob, and he's coming home with me. If you enjoyed this episode, let us know, leave us a comment, also subscribe for future episodes, and I'll see you in the next one.